A busy day for gold prices as they go lower again, about $100 lower from last Friday's settle. Recall last Friday we settled at around 1950. Monday's news about a vaccine really shot all risk assets up to the moon. We saw gold prices decline significantly on that day, but on Tuesday we saw a little bit of a rebound. Wednesday, not so much. Back towards those 1850 lows. We didn't get quite there that low today, but you know, in all this, as after the dust settles, we are looking for some positives out of this. Obviously, a vaccine to the virus is key. How will it help develop the economies that have struggled over these last 6 to 8 months? But certainly the central banks aren't going away and our Fed is no exception. So watch for the Fed to stay in play, which means gold prices do have some upside here as they will continue to keep rates at zero. They'll continue to keep buying, purchasing assets. That is not going to change here in the short term. So these gold price movements, while we do see them ebb and flow with equity movements on the opposite side, could look for upside to continue here, given the fact that the Fed is not going away despite a vaccine or any kind of virus solution. Secondly, let's go over to the dollar. How did the dollar affect gold prices? Well, the dollar has been trending lower going back towards the end of October. It has seen a significant move higher and hasn't backtracked. So we got all the way down the dollar index to that 92 level or close to it. We've rallied up towards 93 and actually got through 93. So right now we're at the midpoint of that, you know, that month and a half range in the dollar index. That strong dollar is going to keep putting pressure on gold at this point. The two still work inversely. We have seen moments where they trade in tandem. That's rare, but we have seen it. This is not one of those times. Dollar stronger, gold lower. Lastly, positioning speculators, while they remain long, you know, going back to near five-year highs, certainly they are going to be looking to getting out on these types of moves, these $100, $50 type moves in gold. We do typically see speculators getting out. 1850 becomes a significant level. If you see a trade south of there, look for long speculators to get out again, or at least continue to get out. And if we see a bounce back up, that 100-day moving average towards 1911, look for them to get back in. So it's momentum trades that we'll keep an eye on watching those speculators. So on a Veterans Day, we'd see gold prices down again, but not yet through that critical 1850 level.